Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to explain part 40 of Java for Tester series, that is types of typecasting. Before I explain or show you the different types of typecasting, we have to first understand what exactly typecasting is. So I already explained what is typecasting as part of the previous video. The current video session, let me recap typecasting at a high level first. So guys, generally we have different literals and different data types in Java. There may be some situations where, okay, let's say there is a situation where we have a variable of in data type and you are assigning some integer literal. Okay, so here data type is int data type, literal is this 9. If you are assigning the integer literal to a variable of int data type, there is no conversion required. There is no typecasting or conversion between literals and data types is required. It's not required, guys. It's not required to convert this integer literal to the required literal for assigning it to the variable of the int data type, because this is also integer literal and this is also int data type. So there is no need of any conversion or typecasting required in this case. But there may be some situations where, let's say there is a variable A, and let's say we have a data type like long data type, and you are assigning some integer literal to this data type. Okay, we are assigning some integer literal to this variable of long data type. Here guys, conversion is required. Here conversion is required, and you know, don't have to explicitly convert here. This 9, that is integer literal 9, will be automatically converted by Java internally, guys. Java will internally convert this integer literal to long literal and assign it to the variable of long data type. And this is part of typecasting, guys. Okay, as part of typecasting, Java will internally convert this integer literal to the long literal for assigning it to the variable of long data type. And there may be some situations, guys. Let's say there may be some situations where we have int A is equal to, and you are assigning some long literal. So this is another case, guys. Okay, you are assigning the long literal to the variable of int data type. Here long literal is there, here int data type is there. Here Java cannot automatically convert, guys. Okay, here here also typecasting is required in order to convert this long literal to this variable of int data type. Okay, we also need to do typecasting, but here Java will not automatically, here in case of this, Java was automatically converting the integer literal to the long data type, long literal type. Okay, but here in case of this example, long literal cannot be automatically converted or internally converted by Java to the integer literal. That's not possible. Here we have to do explicitly typecast. That is, we have to say int A is equal to, you have to typecast like this, int of 9. All these things I explained in the previous video, guys. You can go through that. So here we have, this is called as typecasting, guys. And typecasting is of two types. One is like automatic typecasting, where Java will internally convert the literals to the required literal types, whereas in other cases Java cannot internally convert the literals to the required type, where we have to explicitly convert. Okay, explicitly perform the typecasting, that is like this. We are explicitly converting the or typecasting the long literal to the int literal type, okay, int data type. So guys, what is typecasting now? So after this explanation, you have to say that, we can say that typecasting is nothing but internally, that is automatically or explicitly converting a literal type to the required data type. Okay, so automatically or explicitly converting a value of literal type to the required data type variable, okay, is called as typecasting. Yes, this is called as typecasting. Either this can be done internally by Java if it is possible, or we have to explicitly typecast. explicitly typecast. All these things, how to internally convert and how to explicitly convert and no need to convert and there is no possibility of conversion. Everything I explained in the previous videos about this typecasting, guys. But as part of recapping, what is typecasting? Automatically or explicitly converting a literal type of one type to the required data type of another type. Okay, is called as typecasting. And in this video session, I am going to explain about types of typecasting. Okay, there are two types of typecasting, guys. In Java, there are two types of typecasting. One of the type is widening. Okay, one of the type of typecasting is widening. Widening typecasting. Other type is narrowing typecasting. There are two types of typecasting in Java. One is widening typecasting. Another one is a narrowing typecasting in Java. So, what is widening typecasting and what is narrowing? Let me explain. Okay. So, in case of widening typecasting, if you are assigning smaller sized, if you are assigning smaller sized literal to a variable of bigger sized data type. Smaller size literal, when on assigning the smaller size literal to the bigger size data type, this is known as widening, guys. For example, smaller size literal is, let's say, some integer, okay, 9. And I am assigning this smaller size integer literal, okay, integer literal type, to a variable of bigger size data type, that is long. Okay, if I say long a is equal to 9. Here smaller size literal is there and a bigger sized data type is there. So such kind of thing is known as widening, guys. So here Java will automatically convert. Java will automatically typecast. In case of this, Java will automatically typecast, guys. In case of widening typecasting, Java will automatically typecast. You don't have to explicitly typecast here. Java will automatically do that. Because you are assigning the smaller size literal value to a variable of bigger size data type. So that is possible. Okay, internally or automatically Java will convert it or typecast it. Coming to the narrowing, it is the opposite of the widening, guys, where we have bigger sized literal assigned to the variable of smaller size data type. Okay, smaller size data type. For example, we have something like int a is equal to, if I say 9l, okay, here literal is of bigger size whereas data type is of smaller size. So how to do that? Here we have to do typecasting, but it will not be done automatically like widening. In case of this, we have to explicitly or manually typecast it, that is we have to typecast manually or explicitly like this. Then this particular long literal will be, okay, typecasted or converted into the variable of integer, okay, or int data type. So here explicitly we have to perform typecasting explicitly. Okay, in case of this we have to perform explicit typecasting. In case of this, we have to, Java will automatically typecast. So that's the difference, guys. Okay, implicit and explicit. Fine. So there are two types of typecasting in Java. One is widening typecasting and another one narrowing. In case of widening typecasting, smaller size literals will be assigned to the variables of larger sized data type. Okay, in case of narrowing, the reverse will be there, that is bigger size literals will be assigned to the smaller size data types. Okay, here Java will automatically convert. Okay, typecasting will be done automatically or internally by Java. You don't have to manually specify any or explicitly specify any typecasting in case of widening casting. But in case of narrowing casting, we have to explicitly or manually provide typecasting like this. Okay. So let me practically demonstrate few examples here. Let's go with the widening typecasting first. In case of widening typecasting, the literal size will be small when compared to the data type. For example, we have long data type variable and we are assigning some integer literal to it. The size of the integer literal will be smaller when compared to the long. So here I'm not getting any compiler error because Java is internally converting this or automatically converting this smaller size literal to the variable of the larger sized data type. Okay, this is working. Right click run as Java application. You see it's working fine. Okay, now the next thing here is I will take another example. Let's take there is a variable A. Okay, and we have double here, and this side we have 1.23f. So the floating point literal, which is in smaller size when compared to the data type that is double, right? The literal size is smaller when compared to the data. Okay, the literal size is smaller when compared to the data type size that is double. So here you will not get any error because Java will take care internally. Okay, typecasting will be done by Java automatically or internally, and it will convert this floating point literal to the double literal automatically. So typecasting is not explicitly done, it's implicitly or internally or automatically done by Java. You see, the floating point literal got converted into the long literal, that is a double literal, and assigned to this variable and printed the double literal got printed here. Fine. So the next thing here is the next example we have is narrowing casting. The reverse will happen in case of narrowing. Narrowing type casting is, let's say we have a int a is equal to 9l. Okay, here int a is equal to 9l. This is a long literal which is of bigger size when compared to the data type which is of smaller size. So what's happening? You are getting an error, guys. Okay, since this is bigger than this one, we are getting an error. So we have to do manual or explicitly we have to type cast, guys. Okay, for that explicitly doing that, we have to open and close the circular brackets. In between that you have to say int. Okay, whatever the data type you want to convert, you have to say this long literal to int you are type casting explicitly. Fine. So system.out.println, it will print 9 here. And another example for this narrowing typecasting here is, let's say there is a variable a, okay, which is of float data type, and I'm assigning 1.23, which is nothing but a double data type, okay, double type literal. The size of the double type literal is bigger than the size of the float data type. So that's why we are getting the compiler error. We have to do typecasting. Manually or explicitly we have to typecast to convert such kind of narrowing typecasting cases. So here we have to specify float so that this bigger sized literal will be converted into the smaller sized float data type. So let's run this and see that it will be converted and printed. It is working fine. So, and one more for your reference, guys. So we have this kind of chart here. You can see byte is less than, short is less than, char is less than, int is less than, long, float, double. Why I'm in case of widening, right? In case of widening, if you provide this byte level literal type to the short level, okay, data type, Java will automatically convert. Okay, from here to here, Java will automatically convert this. Okay, if you from left to the literal type is of left type and the data type of variable is of right type, let's say. Okay, if you are assigning byte to short, no need to convert. Java will automatically convert. If even though they are of different literal and data types, Java will automatically convert. So one example we can take here is a float is there here. Okay, floating point literal, if you are assigning to the double data type variable, Java will automatically take care of that. You don't have to do anything. Okay, so here for example, if I float is a literal type and double is a data type. So if I say double a is equal to 1.23f, you don't have to do any conversion, guys. Java will internally or automatically convert using this widening typecasting. Automatically typecasting will be done. But in case of narrowing, this is a flow, that is literal is of double and float is the data type. Okay, the reverse of widening is this one. This is a chart from double, float, long, int, char, short, byte. The chart will go on. Okay, so the same thing here, the reverse thing here, that is here the literal is double and float is the data type. So float a is equal to 1.23, you will get the compiler error. You have to manually type cast or you have to do narrowing type casting, that is explicitly type cast here, then only it will work. Okay, So these are the two types of typecasting that are there in Java, guys. Okay, one is widening casting and another one is narrowing casting. So that's it, guys. In the next video session, I will explain different types of operators in Java. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you.